So my Niger people talk say wahala dey like bicycle wey no get brake. My country people, abeg, I get one matter wey I want table for this platform, okay? But first of all, welcome to my channel. If you're new on this channel, welcome. I'm Nelly Skona, a mom vlogger, content creator that stays here in New York, but I'm from Imo State. So the matter now be say nursery 2 pikin. That's nursery 2 child should be around 5 to 6 years. Carried fufu and egusi to school. Is it right or wrong? Is it proper or improper? So I was just scrolling the jelly on one of the social media platform and I got this post. Just read it and let me hear your opinion in the comment section. Is this proper for a nursery 2 old child to come with a fegusi and fufu? In case you don't know what a fegusi and fufu is, look at the sumptuous food. This is how sumptuous the food looks like. Okay, but the thing is just that the fufu is a starchy food and it's a heavy food. It's a kind of food that after eating it, you will be which word will I use now? You'll be over relaxed. You gotta drop him. So transcribe a bit, interpret what it means for someone to drop him in the comment section. And please mind you, this soup is sumptuous. It is our traditional meal. It is one of the most popular foods we have in Nigeria. Okay, the teacher now is asking this platform whether it is right or wrong. And secondly, can you give your child fufu and egusi to school? Don't be in a haste to answer, okay? You have to think about it, because I'm going to give you guys reasons not to and reasons to at the end of the video. So first of all, let me read some comments in the comment section for you guys. So the person said, please let's not play over this question. It is true that things are hard, but bringing apple and egusi soup is not ideal. Sister, apple and egusi is not cheap. A cup of egusi now in my area is 400 naira. And for you to cook better egusi soup, you have to use like 3 cups or 4 cups depending on the number of family you have. Okay, so the next one said, my reasons are, the child may end up soiling his clothes and even books with the soup. Okay, about soiling the clothes, yes, that one is reasonable, but soiling books, I know there's something called lunchbox where they keep their food, and once it is break time, they don't bring their books out and be eating and reading at the same time. Once it's break time, it's time for you to eat. Okay, so she now went ahead and said, well, with those children, that is not their cultural food, they may even bully such child. Okay, that's right, I agree with her on this. Yes, you know, say this our generation, we too the two woke generation. So someone that used to swallow fufu at home might see a child that her fellow classmates that brought her own fufu to the school and start bullying, you know, and start saying, ha, your mommy cannot buy indomie for you, your mommy cannot buy spaghetti for you, my mommy cannot give me fufu. But at home, they might even be swallowing better correct fufu at home. What kind of school? This is another comment, okay, from another person. What kind of school do some people teach pikonu? That's please. Swallow that we encourage children to bring to school because it's our local dish. Some people are here debating on the morality of it. Some schools even have swallow day. Wow, I'm just hearing of this. So back then when I was in school, there's also like swallow day, but it's also good. Even children who refuse it at home eat it in school. What is wrong with we Nigerians and low self-esteem? this time they are tagging it to our staple food kwa. Oh, chin. Honestly, this is our traditional food, okay? All this indomie, rice, naboru, we borrow all this food. but just that fufu has that bad smell, oneshi. But not all fufu smell shall. You get some fufu where if they do unwell, it no go smell. I've eaten that kind of fufu. What else did she say? It's yes, some children, they don't like swallow, even at home they don't swallow, and it's also a way of encouraging them to eat. Maybe when they see their classmates eating it, they'll be forced to adjust. So let's go over to the next one. This person said, for me, I think it's not proper because after eating the heavy food, a child might doze off. Even we adults, once you finish eating this food, there is no way you can perform as you were before. So I think something light should be taken to school to enable the child to be active in class. I'm talking from experience. Okay, this is a two-way thing, actually. First of all, yes, the food is a heavy food, and secondly, if it's for a school that closes by 4:30, and you, yes, some schools close by 4:30, and you give your child a very, very light food, and you know their break time is usually 11:30, 12. Honestly, if you give your child a very light food, I'm not sure the child is going to sustain that child till 4:30. I think the kind of food you give your child just depends on their closure time. Okay, I'm not saying you should give your child fufu. I'm not saying you should give your child indomie, very light noodles. No, what I'm trying to say is the closure time also helps to determine the type and quantity of food you offer your child, so that you don't starve that child. And secondly, thirdly, about those enough, yes, that fufu can make you all weak and everything, but I know that some children can still eat that fufu and be very, very active. You know, you cannot compare the energy of an adult to that of a child. Some children can swallow that comfortably and still be hyperactive and very attentive. So it all boils down on your type of child. Like my children now, if my first child has told me, mommy, please give me fufu and swallow. Give me swallow, not necessarily fufu. What did you tell mommy?
I don't eat soup in the school.
You want to go to school with curry and soup?
Yes.
Which soup?
Curry and soup together.
Which soup?
Opono soup.
Opono. Is it not opono? Say obono.
Obono soup.
You've heard from the horse's mouth. So the next one is, I'm a teacher. There was a time I was teaching in nursery 2. One of my pupil brought apple and egusi soup to school. All the pupils in the class were laughing and I asked what was happening. That's the bully we are talking about. I think this is not the problem of bringing apple and egusi. This is the point where we mothers just have to teach our children not to bully, not to laugh at their classmates because of the type of food they go to school with. But I can understand, this is nursery 2 students, pupils, so they will not really understand what life is all about anyways, and they will just do what they want to do. Nursery 2 children, they are just kids. Yes, so the little girl was crying. I have to make sure she stopped crying. When the mom came to pick her, I advised her not to give her that to school again. It affects the child emotionally, so it is not advisable to give that to a child. Thanks. The garri and soup the child brought to school is not what is affecting the child emotionally. It is the children that laughed at her. So I think this is where parents come in. Okay, tell your child that you just have to respect each other's meal. Yes, everybody in your class must not come with what you come to school with. Yes, so in my own opinion, the teacher is not supposed to tell the parents what to give to her child and what not to give to her child. Like, the parents gave the child what he or she has had. So the teacher is wrong. I think what the teacher is supposed to do is to caution those children that laughed and made jests of the girl. Warn them, give them stern warning. Tell them to their face that it is wrong to laugh at your classmates' food. That is what the teacher would have done, and not this action. Yeah, what do you guys think? Drop it in the comment section. So, in my own opinion, is giving your child fufu and egusi soup or just general soup advisable? It all boils down to you. Just do you. If it is garri and soup you want to give your child, good. As long as your child loves to swallow, even if your child even if your child does not like swallowing, it's also a way to see if the teachers can make that child to learn how to swallow. Yes, these schools these days, they have main teacher and they have assistant teacher. The assistant teacher is always there to help do all the small errands. Maybe take the children to pee, take them to arrange their lunch for them, make sure they eat in a good environment, clear their plates. That's the work of the assistant teacher. Yes, so as long as a child is fine with it, and you too, you are fine with it, just do you. And another thing, because from what I read earlier, some children have that, take that advantage to bully their classmates that come with fufu. So I will also say, if you're giving your child such food, such traditional food, just let him or her know that this is what to expect, but be confident, this is your traditional food. Okay, sure, you eat it at home, so don't make anyone, as in, just boost that child's confidence. Okay, so that when the child takes it to school, ingo the swallowing fufu, even if the classmates laugh, it won't even touch, because he or she has already been pre-informed by you. So this is something I can do. This is something I can do, honestly, because this my boy, he likes swallow. If you leave this boy, he's going to swallow from morning, afternoon, night. He doesn't give a damn. Okay, so I'll be rounding off this video. Sorry I couldn't show my face. I've been so busy these days. Okay, I just had to squeeze out time, okay, and do it this way. Maybe next time. And secondly, my second phone, the T-Farm, there's no how I can do reaction video without, you know, looking at the what they call it, either where I got the source. Yes, the source, like looking out at phone, or you know what I mean now. So I don't know how to explain it, so I just had to do it like this. Okay, so I will see you guys in my next video. If you watched or if you listened up to here, I truly appreciate, and I would love to hear your opinion in the comment section, and I'll be signing out. Bye bye guys.